So you know what we should do today? I think that we should talk about the differences between the 2022 limited GMC Sierra AT4 and what it is you're going to get if you step up and wait for the 2022 refreshed GMC Sierra AT4X. And what I want to start by doing is giving a little overview on what you're getting for the 2022 AT4 and why it is that the AT4X is going to cost a bit more money if you wait for it to arrive. So if you're in the market for a GMC Sierra and you didn't already know this, GMC has just recently released what they call the 2022 GMC Sierra refreshed models. What we're looking at right now is a 2022 GMC Sierra Limited. If you don't know the differences, that is one of the things I'm going to tell you today when I'm talking about the differences between the AT4 that we're looking at now and the AT4X. If you didn't already know this, also the refreshed GMC Sierras are going to be able to be ordered in December. They're going to start being built in February, all things, you know, going according to plan, and you'll start seeing the first ones arriving in the spring. Whereas right now, this is a 2022 we're looking at. You can currently get a 2022 on the lot, hopefully, if your dealership has one. And they're just going to be a carryover truck until the refresh versions start arriving. You can actually probably even find the odd 2021. And the 2022 Limited and the 2021 are very much the same truck, minus a couple little details. In fact, one of the details is actually on this AT4. You used to be able to get a GMC Sierra AT4 with a 5.3 liter, but for the 2022 Limited, you can only get it with the 3 liter, or what we have in this one right here, the 6.2 liter. But what I want to talk about first is, in terms of the AT4 and the AT4Xs coming out, what are some of the similarities? What are some of the things that are going to be the same? And then I'm going to go on and talk about what are some of the main differences and why it is that the AT4X is going to come in at a definitely a higher price tag. Now, first and foremost, both of these trucks are going to come with a 2-inch suspension lift from the factory. They are both geared towards being, you know, off-roady. We'll say this right off the top, the AT4X has more off-road options, which we are going to talk about, of course. Now, the AT4 also is going to come in a higher trim level. So it's automatically going to come with leather seats in the front and the back. The AT4X is also going to come with leather seats, but there's some additional features with those leather seats, which again, we will talk about. Factory remote start's going to be on both of these. Of course, factory heated seats and the ability to have AC seats. I do believe that the AT4X is going to come standard with the AC seats, whereas the AC seats are an option when it comes to the AT4. You can actually get an AT4 with simply just the heated seats, pardon me. The other things, of course, crew cab, of course, right? The difference that I'm understanding right now, though, is with the AT4, the current AT4, you can get the 5'8" box or the 6.5-foot box, pardon me. With the new AT4X, my understanding is only the 5'8" box is going to be available. Both are going to have the option, of course, for the 6-position multi-pro tailgate. My understanding, though, is the AT4X is going to come standard with the kicker audio system, which comes down right there. Whereas AT4, you don't have to get that kicker audio system, so obviously it's going to come in at a lower price tag because of that. And also going forward, the 2022 refreshed AT4 will have that option as well. Of course, sunroof is going to be in both of these trucks, sliding rear window as well. And the sunroof, again, is not a big moonroof, people. It is a regular sunroof like we've had for the past, you know, few years, right? Now, underneath the hood is where I want to go next. One of the few, as far as I'm concerned, advantages that our current AT4 has, and something you might want to consider over the AT4X, is the fact that you do get 2 engine choices, as I mentioned earlier, when it comes to the current AT4, the 2022 Limited. Right now, of course, this is a 6.2 liter. That is going to be the standard engine when it comes to the AT4X. The difference is, on our current AT4, the 2022 Limited, you are able to get it with the 3-liter Duramax turbo diesel, which I myself love that engine. I know many of you do. And when I've been doing the videos on the AT4X, that's one of the biggest, you know, comments I get is, Jeff, when are they going to have, or are they going to have the ability to have the diesel motor in that? And as of right now, no. So if you're looking for the diesel, you might want to consider getting the 2022 Limited. Now, one of the next differences is an interesting one, and that is coming to due to the tire and rim size. So first and foremost, if you get a 2022 Limited GMC Sierra AT4, you have the option for an 18 or a 20-inch tire. And there is wheel. And in both those cases, there's a different tire. If you get the 18-inch wheel, the tire is going to be a Goodyear Wrangler DuraTrack. In fact, the size is going to be a 265/70/18. Whereas you also have the option for a 20-inch wheel wrapped by the Goodyear Wrangler Territory tires. Now,
as far as I can see so far, the AT4X is only going to come with black 18-inch aluminum wheels. It doesn't look as though there's an option for a 20-inch wheel, which kind of makes sense if it's an off-road vehicle. It has a different tire size though, 275, 65, 18. So not really sure. I was hoping and anticipating it was going to be a much larger tire, but from what I'm seeing, it is not. So those are your different options. Again, and both of the wheels, by the way, in the current AT4 Limited are going to be like this machined aluminum type of color, again, where it's going to be the black when it comes to the 2022 refreshed AT4X.
As far as towing, by the way, you are going to have the option for towing, tow haul mode, the tow options on both of these trucks. But for whatever reason, it sounds as though our current 2022 Limited AT4 is going to have a little bit more tow capacity. I believe we're around 9,100-9,200 pounds, whereas I've read two different numbers on the AT4X coming out at 86 or 8,900 pounds. So at the top level, 8,900 pounds. So you're going to get a few hundred more pounds towing when it comes to our current AT4.
By the way, are you liking these videos, doing these comparison videos, these walk around videos? If so, please make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any more great content like this. And I would love it if you hit that like button because that helps me out as well.
Next, what I want to do is go underneath and talk about suspension differences. So when you do get the AT4X, the standard suspension is what you see right here, or pardon me, the AT4, the 2022 Limited AT4, you're going to get the Rancho name band trucks as part of the X31 off-road package. However, when you do get the AT4X, it is a much higher end suspension. It is the Multimatic DSS3 suspension. We've seen that on the Colorado ZR2. It's coming out on the new Silverado ZR2 and of course now on the AT4X. It's gonna allow for more suspension travel. I think it's around 50 millimeters front and 25 millimeters rear of more travel. And it's just the ride itself. It is gonna give you a much better ride off road because they're just a high intensity shock that is going to read the terrain. So if you're on a normal road, like you're out here driving, okay, it's going to not only give you that soft ride when you're on the roads like that, but it's going to stiffen up when you're on the aggressive stuff, right? The real off-road terrain. It's going to give you a much better ride when it comes to that.
Obviously, there is a front end change in terms of looks as well. The relocation of the fog lights, if I can move my finger in the right way, are in a different spot. The grille is a different size. The C-shaped lights are different. And even down here, this area here is also different as well. And you can see that. I'll show you the picture here of the current AT4X coming out, or the 2022 refresh AT4X coming out, pardon me. So there is a different cosmetic front end. In terms of the actual side of the vehicle, not a whole lot different when it comes to looks of the side. And the back remains virtually untouched. The back of the rear end of the truck is pretty much the same between the AT4 2022 Limited and the AT4X refresh.
One cool thing that GMC has done, what I like what they did this actually last year when it comes to the AT4s, is they have this high step you're gonna get on our current 2021 or 2022 Limited GMC Sierra AT4s. So it's kind of rock guarded, and obviously, as you can see, it's higher up. And it's a thinner, for better ground clearance running board, right? And I like that. One of the things they've added for the AT4X as an option is you're going to have rock sliders here, right? Rock guards. So basically, there won't be a running board there for those of you who don't care. And it's going to be a bar that goes underneath that's going to protect you when you're riding over those rocks if you are actually using the truck as an off-road truck. Despite the fact that many more changes are coming inside the vehicle, we're going to get there in a second. There are two more things I want to talk about in regards to the outside of the truck, to the performance when it comes to off-road. And number one of those things is the fact that if you get the AT4X refresh truck, you have the ability to have something called terrain mode. That means when you put the truck in four low in terrain mode, you have something called one pedal drive. That allows you to control the truck with literally just the one pedal. That means if you take your foot off the brake, it'll slow the truck right down. In fact, all the way to a complete stop. So you don't need to keep, changing your foot from the gas to the brake. The other main difference, of course, and I'm sure if you haven't heard this already, this is one of the biggest differences in the truck. When it comes to the AT4X, you now have the ability to have front and rear locking differential like we currently see on our ZR2 Colorado. That is an amazing upgrade when it comes to an off-road truck, the fact that you can manually press a button and lock your front and rear differentials. But you know what? Let's head inside because that's where a lot more changes are coming. Now, the overall dimensions of both of these trucks are going to be virtually the exact same. So your back seat, which we've already shown you a little bit ago, is going to remain the exact same, other than, of course, there is a difference in the leather. In fact, there is a higher end leather for sure that I think, more detail. You got black, you got ceramic white piping that you're going to get in the AT4X versus the Kalahari, trim that we're seeing right now in the AT4. So you're going to get a bit more when it comes to that. The other thing, of course, is the fact right here, your power adjustability currently on our AT4 is an eight-way adjustable seat. When it comes to the new AT4X, it's going to be a 16-way seat. Not only that, but it's also going to have massaging seats. So that seat you're seeing right now in this truck for the AT4X is going to be massaging, just like we're seeing on our Cadillacs, and that is pretty awesome. Now, as far as the stereo system, of course, we have the Bose stereo system in our current 2022 Limited AT4, but when you get to the AT4X, it's going to be the CenterPoint Bose stereo system. But here is where things get interesting, and here is where I know a lot of people are going to want to change when it comes from their current AT4 to the AT4X. However, again, a different price tag comes on that, and for some of you, it may not be that crucial. Well, first and foremost, both of these trucks are going to have the rear view camera mirror, all right? As you can see, it's a camera. I've talked about that in numerous videos before. HD camera, of course, that will, it's all the time streaming. So it's not like a backup camera. It is a rear view camera mirror that you can flip off, pardon me, if you don't want it. But that is not where the differences come in. The differences are going to come in this area here, and this area here. And let's just start here. So currently right now in an AT4, you have some digital, you know, configuration. You have down here and you have up here, but you have on the outside analog gauges. When it comes to the new 2022 refreshed AT4X, this whole area here is going to be a 12.3-inch programmable screen that's in front of you with some different options in terms of how you want the layout to look. So definitely more modernized, more refreshed look you're gonna find in front of that area there. Next difference, of course, is right over here. Something that I've heard so many complaints about, so many people frustrated with, for those people who are techie like myself. This is currently an 8-inch color touchscreen, which I think it obviously serves its purpose. However, the new screen, like many of us have wanted, is going to be a 13.4-inch color touchscreen. The other difference, though, of course, is not only is it going to be a larger screen, it's going to have different integration in terms of right now, as you look at this AT4, you're going to see that it has, you know, your regular GM icons. When it comes to the AT4X, however, it is going to be using Google integration. So all of this stuff is going to be operated essentially by Google. That does not mean that you're going to lose out on your Apple CarPlay if you're an Apple person, or even your Android Auto for that matter. It is just going to be that the icons are going to be controlled through Google, and you're going to have some Google integration, which is kind of cool actually as well. And I think it's going to be a step up because obviously they know what they're doing in terms of, you know, that kind of stuff. The other main difference, of course, is going to come right here. The shifter. So right now, currently, if you want a column shifter in a high-end truck, you have got to get yourself into this current AT4, the 2022 AT4, because whether you get a 2022 refresh, regular AT4, or the AT4X that we've been comparing it to, right down here is going to be an electric center console shift. So gone is the charger right here. It's obviously relocated, but you're not going to have all this area. It is going to have a shifter in place of. So I know for a lot of you, that does make a big difference. So I think I've nailed it. I think I've told you all the differences when it comes to the AT4X that's coming out versus our current 2021/2022 limited GMC Sierra AT4. Now, which one is the one you're gonna wanna get? Does it matter to you that it's that much more money because are those features outweighing the price? Or are you looking at going, you know what? I'm just gonna get in one of these while I can right now. Price is a bit lower. I don't need all that different tech. I'm not gonna be off-roading it as hard. This is still a very capable off-road truck. So maybe I'll stick with this. I'm curious what you think. Anyways, as always, thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for the next video, everybody. Take care.